Before we get too far into Project Rusty, we wanted to give it a mechanical once-over just to make sure, see what we're up against. Rather than go it alone, we thought we'd call our good mates from DriveTech 4x4, Ben Lavis, who we got here to show us what we're doing. G'day, Ben.
Oi, Dick.
So tell me what the plan is.
Well, it's probably a pretty big plan. usually before you buy a vehicle like this, you'd probably want to do some checks before you do
I've
buy it.
I've never been accused of being smart, mate.
Yeah. Look, now that we have got the vehicle, I think there's some pretty basic checks that we can go through.
Yep.
The vehicle's been sitting here overnight, so I think the first check we can do is do a cold start,
See
if we can hear any unusual rattles or anything going on the engine. And then I think we should get out on the road, take it for a bit of a test drive, Run through some things like the braking system, apply the brakes, see if there's any shaking in the wheel. Obviously, feel the steering wheel, make sure there's no clunks, go from lock to lock, make sure there's no unusual feelings or shudder in the wheel.
Yep.
And really just check to see how the vehicle feels.
Make sure it's all smooth.
Yeah, exactly right. And then we'll bring it back in here, we'll chuck on the hoist, Get it up, and see what we're looking at, and maybe Run some other checks.
Well, she ain't pretty underneath, mate, but I'm sure you'll be able to sort it out.
I'll put the safety goggles
on.
Yeah,
I think we'll get into it. Yeah, too easy.
All right, Dex, do you want to start her up? Alright, Dex, shut her off. Alright, so I think we've been pretty lucky here. There's been no unusual smoke, there's been nothing white or blue. There was no big puff of black, so I think we're looking pretty good for this test. Righto, now we've done the cold start check. I think we'll get in the car and we'll get out in the road and see what we can find on the road. So I've just jumped inside Project Rusty here, and the first thing I've done obviously is just put my foot on the clutch, and it actually feels quite spongy, and there's a fair bit of noise coming from the clutch release bearing, so I think the clutch out is definitely going to be on the list of things to do. So there's a few things we've found immediately with this car. We've checked the steering, there's a few unusual creaks and rattles when we've turned the wheel, the brakes are possibly a little bit suspect. The clutch has definitely got a bit of an unusual noise and some bearing noises there. So we're just going to pop down here and do a quick brake test, and then we'll get it back into the workshop and see what we need to look at. Okay, yeah, look, the brakes feel pretty good. Let go of the wheel, there's no pulling. They feel a little bit soft, but we'll definitely get up on the hoist and just make sure everything's 100% before we go any further. Righto, so we've just brought Project Rusty back from its initial test drive. It actually doesn't feel too bad. I mean, it's had a bit of a hard life, but let's get up on the hoist and see what we can figure out with some of those suspect noises. Righto. Yeah, so obviously you can see there's corrosion everywhere. Some of these boots are dry, they need to be replaced. I think there's going to be a lot of trouble trying to get a lot of this stuff off because of the corrosion. So you can see under here the front tail shaft universal joint is shot, and there's heaps of movement there. That's going to cause some pretty serious vibrations, and I think it's because the car's been running in full drive for most of its life. The pinion bearing's also shot, there's movement in there, and we've got some leaking going on down in the back of the diff cover there. Righto, so you can see here too, the exhaust hanger is cracked, so the exhaust is just hanging there. And that's just purely from the probably constant corrugated roads and obviously the corrosion. You look at the corrosion here, obviously the leaf springs and shackles and bushes are all worn, going to have to be replaced. And I dare say there's going to be a lot of 4-inch grinder activity going on to get all that stuff off. Righto, we've had a pretty good look underneath, so we're going to drop it down the ground, get these hub locks off, check the steering, and then have a quick look under the bonnet. Righto, so just looking under the engine bay here, everything actually looks pretty good. Yeah, there's no obvious signs of oil leaks. We've checked the condenser, we've checked the radiator, we've checked the fan clutch. Everything seems like it has been reasonably well maintained. The only things I think we need to look at obviously is there's a battery here which is a little bit suspect and loose. There's some weird things like this wire here, and there's a whole bunch of wires that we don't know what they are. There's some other aftermarket accessories that have been fitted, which probably need to be removed and redone, I think, so we know where everything's at. There's also some hoses that need to be replaced. They're quite crunchy. They're also swollen, so I'd get them done straight away. But all in all, looks pretty good. Righto, so when we were out driving before, we heard a bit of a clunk in the steering, so I'm under here trying to work out where it's coming from. I've got Dex sitting in the driver's seat. Dex, do you want to just start going left to right on the wheel and we can see if we can find any movement in the steering joints here? You can actually see one of these tire ends is shot. There's plenty of movement and it's clunking away, so that's an easy fix. We better get that done pretty soon, I reckon.
So what's the verdict, Ben?
Mate, it's not too bad.
Oh, that's good news.
Yeah, considering it is an ex-coal mine vehicle.
Yeah. Yeah.
There's a fair bit of corrosion and bits and pieces in there.
Yeah, it's to be expected, isn't it?
Yeah. Exactly right, yeah. And look, there's a few obvious things that need attention straight away.
Yep.
But all in all, I think we've got a pretty good project.
Yeah, got our work cut out for us, eh?
Absolutely, mate, yeah.
we'll get everyone the job.
That's it, get involved, for sure.
That's it, yeah. Well, look, mate, thanks heaps for coming out and giving us your expert opinion on old Project Rusty. And,
no problem at all.
Yeah, mate, I'm sure we'll be seeing you again soon.
Yeah, looking forward to being involved in the process.
All right. No worries, Ben. Cheers, thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot, bye.